Hello to all of you and welcome back to another easy PowerPoint text animation tutorial. The animation is inspired by one of the Nawaz Alamgir motion graphics animations. The link to his portfolio website is given in the video description. Let's get started with a new presentation and set the layout to blank. Go to the Insert tab and choose any style you like from the WordArt drop-down menu. Type the text and then format the text as you like. It is preferable to apply only the outline color and remove the text fill color from the Shape Format tab. Move the text on top of the slide and then start making duplicates either using the copy and paste command, or you can drag and drop the text box while holding the Control key. To make further copies with the exact distance, you can either press the Control Y or F4 key. We are taking a total of 8 text boxes. Now, right-click on an empty area of the slide and choose Format Background and choose any of your favorite colors. Then apply a text fill color to the first letter of the first text box. As we need to apply the same text fill to the second letter of the second text box and third letter of the third box and so on, you can again use the F4 key or Control Y shortcut to repeat the last command. It is time to apply the animation effects to the text boxes. Select the first top text box and then go to the Animations tab, click Add Animation drop-down menu, and open More Motion Paths. Apply the down motion path from the list. Adjust the length of the down motion path and drop its endpoint exactly on top of the 8th text box. Open the animation pane, set the effect to start with previous with a time duration of 4 seconds. Double-click the effect from the animation pane to open the effect options properties window. You can also try a different time duration and can adjust the start and end smoothness as you like. Make a checkmark on the auto reverse option as we want the first text box to move down up to the 8th box and then return. From the Timings tab, set it to repeat until the end of the slide. As we need to apply the same down motion path to the next 3 text boxes, so you can use the animation painter to replicate the same animation effect over them. Select the first text box and then click the animation painter twice and then start clicking on the next text boxes up to the 4th text box. Close the animation painter by pressing the escape key. Now you need to adjust the length of these down motion paths. Select the second motion path and adjust its length up to the 7th text box. Then select the third motion path effect and adjust its length up to the 6th text box. And finally the 4th effect and drop its endpoint over the 5th text box. You can hold down the Shift key while adjusting the endpoint of the motion path. See, the slideshow and half of our animation are complete. It's time to move the bottom 4 text boxes upwards. So, select the 8th text box and apply the up motion path from the Add Animations drop-down menu. Configure the same effect option properties for this effect as we did for the down motion path. The endpoint of this up motion path should be matched the first text box. You can then again take the help of Animation Painter to apply the same up motion path to the 7th, 6th, and 5th text boxes. Then adjust the endpoint motion path length of the 7th text box with the 2nd, sixth text box length should match with the third text box, and drop the fifth text box motion path endpoint over the fourth text box. See the slideshow, and there you have it. To make this animation a bit more interesting, select all the effects from the animation pane. Select the first one and then hold down the Shift key and then click on the last effect. Right-click and choose Effect Options. Change the animate text from all at once to by letter. You can configure the delay between letters and the default as 10%. See the slideshow, and there you have a different output just by changing an option. So, I hope you will find this tutorial informative and interesting. Let me know your thoughts by liking, sharing, and commenting. Subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications, as there are a lot more tutorials to come. Thanks a lot for your time. Bye and have a happy weekend.